Hey guys, my name is Milan and today I would like to show you this cheap and handy GSM alarm iGet M2B. This video will be a complete guide through the settings of this GSM alarm. Please check the description of this video where you can jump on any chapter very quickly through hyperlink. Let's start with a quick introduction. In case of power outage, we have backup batteries here. Here we have full-size SIM card slot. First we will need to slide left like this and open it. We will put here our SIM card, which wasn't included in the package. After this, just push and slide to the right and SIM card is correctly on its place. Here we will put the power. And after all this, you need to turn on the unit on this place. Right now we will need to wait for a few seconds and the unit will be ready for first configuration. Okay, we are ready. First, we will enter into the setup by entering 8888. You need to be very quick. And for leaving the setup, hit star hashtag. So once again. First thing, we will set up the clock. The code is 32. Now you will enter the current year, 21. Month is 2, date 10, current time 16 hour 22 minutes and 0 seconds, and hashtag. Just leave the setup and correct time is set. In this chapter I will show you the remote controller. It has four basic buttons: arm, disarm, home arm, and panic button. We will enter the setup. And code for adding remote is 20. You will need to choose number for this remote. So we will choose 1 and hitting hashtag. After this icon appears, you will need to hit any button. Okay, we are all set. When the remote is working properly, the central unit is making a beep sound, just like this. If you want to delete your remote, the code is 21, number of your remote, in our case 1, and hitting hashtag. And as you can see, the remote isn't working anymore, because when the remote is working properly, the central unit is making a beep sound. We have a motion detector here with battery already inside. So all we need to do is turn it on and we will add this wireless sensor into this unit. The code for adding any wireless sensor is 23. You need to choose a number of the sensor. We will choose 01 hashtag, and now we will need to make a movement. So the sensor is successfully added into the central unit. If the motion sensor was added successfully, you can check it with the making a motion and you will see a blue backlight on the central unit. In this chapter, I will show you defense zone programming. The code is 60. Number of our sensor is 01. Defense zone type could be number 1, real time, number 2, 40 seconds delay, number 3, 24 hours, number 4, bypass. We will choose number 2. Alarm type could be number 1 SOS, number 2 fire, number 3 gas leak, number 4 door, number 5 hall, number 6 window, number 7 balcony, number 8 boundary. We will choose number 5 hall. And the last step is if you want to siren go on, number 1, or you want to siren go off, which is 0, we will choose 0 and hashtag. As we saw, number 01 was our sensor and it was done successfully. In case you want to delete any wireless sensor, you will need to use a code 24. 24, number of the sensor was 01. Confirmed, 01 was deleted from the central unit. For this alarm, it's possible to set timer for arm. It's possible to set up to 3 activations from number 33 to 35. We will choose 33. Our time will be 10 p.m. And timer for this arm, you can choose from time slots from 36 up to 38. We will choose 36 and we want to disarm at 6 a.m. We are all set. If you set the timer previously and you want to turn it on, then the code is 39 and number 1 for turn it on, and you can see the icon of timer here. And if you want to turn it off, the code is same, 39 and 0 for turn it off. We can set arm delay. The code is 44. We want 3 seconds, 03, hashtag. We are all set and we will try it now. We are armed. The default password for this arm is 1234. Hashtag. This function is effective only when you are using central unit keyboard. When you activate alarm through remote controller / wireless keyboard / by SMS, arm is immediate without any delay. Anyway, I strongly recommend you to hide this unit very well in your apartment and control your alarm only through this remote. In this alarm, we can add up to 6 numbers for calls. The codes are from 51 to 56. We will choose 51. And now the phone number. We are all set. And if we want to delete phone number, the code is exactly 51, hashtag, and 51 was deleted. You can set up to 3 SMS receiving numbers. From 57 up to 59. We will choose 57 and the phone number. Hashtag. We are all set. If you want to delete SMS receiving number, you will choose the code for your number and hashtag. It was deleted. Default setting for SMS notification for arming and disarming is off. If you would like to turn it on, the code is 77. Number 1 for turning on, number 0 for turning off. We would like to turn it on, number 1, hashtag. We are all set. Now, every time if someone will arm or disarm your alarm, you will receive a SMS notification. If you want to set alarm delay, there's a code 45. 45. Number of seconds from 1 to 99, we will choose 10. We are all set. This setting is effective only when a defense zone type is set to option 2, which was by default 40 seconds delay defense zone. And now we will check our 10 seconds delay zone. When alarm was activated, I will receive a SMS notification with information which defense zone triggered alarm, in my case hall alarm. Great thing is, alarm will also call you. In this step we will connect the siren and remember the red cable is positive one. Please be careful because the siren is very loud. Now we will turn it on. Imagine you are outside and some family member at home is in trouble. He will need to push this emergency button and the alarm will let you know. It will also call you. And in case you want to turn on siren in this emergency event, I will show you how. The code is 76 and for turning on siren number 1. Or for turning off siren is 0. In this part, I will explain to you home arm defense zone setting. Imagine you are at home and your alarm is disarmed, but at the same time you want to have active your sensor in garage. You will use your remote controller and this button. As you can see, home arm is now active. And you will deactivate it like usually. But if you want to have active sensor in your garage during home arm activated, you need to set up sensor first. Code is 61, number of your sensor 01, and for activation 1, hashtag. We are set. Before installing of central unit, you should check the GSM signal in desired place. The intensity number should be within 7 to 31. Code for this operation is 81, hashtag. My number is 18, so I'm good. If your number is less than 7, you should change place of your unit. In this step, I will show you how you'll receive SMS notifications about power outage. First, we need to be armed. And now I will unplug the power. I already received a SMS notification about it. And it will be same when I will bring the power back. See? In this step, I would like to show you how you can arm your alarm over the SMS. Just enter default operation password 1234 and number 1 for arm. The other command is 1234 and number 2 for disarm. And the last SMS command is 12343 for alarm record checking. Now, this is very important step. We will be changing settings password. The code is 31 and we will choose our new password 2846 # We will check it 2846 and it's working. In case you want to disarm alarm through this keyboard, you need to know operating password. By default it's 1234. But of course we would like to change this password. We will enter into the settings. Code for changing operating password is 30 and we will choose our new password, for example. We are all set.